Hello, this is Ken Drews from the National Weather Service in Tucson. This video will recap where rainfall has been the best thus far this monsoon and what's in store for the remainder of the season. Remember, the official start of the monsoon was June 15th and the end will be September 30th. This is a total of 108 days. Day 54 of the monsoon is August 7th, so let's take a look at how we're doing for rainfall in southeast Arizona near the midpoint of monsoon 2015. Shown on the left is rainfall that occurred during June. As you can see by the yellow and dark green colors, some areas received anywhere from 1.5 to 3 inches of rain in June. It should be noted that some areas did receive 1/4 to 3/4 of an inch of rain during the first part of June, which is not technically part of the monsoon total. In any event, most areas were either normal or wetter than normal in June, as shown on the right. In July, many areas received between 2 and 5 inches of rainfall, as shown in yellow and orange on the left, with some mountain locales tallying 5 to 8 inches. Meanwhile, many areas from Tucson westward received less than 2 inches of rain. This is depicted better on the map on the right that shows locations that were an inch or two drier than normal during July in yellow and orange. The map on the left shows the rainfall received thus far during the monsoon through August 8th, and the map on the right shows the amount either above or below normal for the past 60 days ending August 9th. On the left, you can see that most of the rainfall has occurred over mountains and to the south or east of Tucson, with the highest totals generally ranging from 6 to 12 inches. More telling is the map on the right, which shows that the majority of southeast Arizona has tallied rainfall totals within an inch of normal for this point. Also note that there are a number of locations that were 1 to 3 inches below normal, as shown in yellow, and others that were 1 to 3 inches above normal, as shown in green. Now let's take a look back at the Climate Prediction Center's rain forecast made earlier this year. The outlooks for June through August, top left, and July through September, lower left, projected that northeast Arizona stood the best chance of receiving above normal rainfall, although as you can see, the projected above normal area does shift into far southeast Arizona with time. Meanwhile, equal chances of wetter, drier, or near normal rainfall were predicted elsewhere across the state. The map on the right shows the percentage of normal rainfall received thus far during the monsoon, from June 15th through August 8th. By and large, northeast Arizona did receive above normal rainfall as indicated in the greens and blues. In southeast Arizona, there are some greens and blues, but also a lot of brown, which indicated below normal rainfall. So you could definitely say that rainfall has been hit or miss thus far this monsoon in southeast Arizona, although those closest to the New Mexico border have fared somewhat better. Incidentally, the bright blue pockets indicating much above normal rainfall in western Arizona, those are thanks to moisture ushered in by Hurricane Dolores. The equal chances forecast in southeast Arizona was influenced by a number of factors that resulted in conflicting signals. The presence of El Nino favored drier conditions, while the projected dominant position of the monsoon high to our north favored wetter conditions. At the time, long-term climate models also favored wetter conditions. As you probably remember, we are currently in a developing El Nino, meaning sea surface temperatures in the equatorial Pacific Ocean are warmer than average. These tables show various cities across southeast Arizona and the number of years monsoon rainfall was either above, below, or near normal when an El Nino was present. While El Nino quite often leads to a drier than normal monsoon, that is not always the case, with some El Nino monsoons actually ending up wetter than normal. From the maps of monsoon 2015 rainfall shown earlier, some areas were indeed dry while others had already received respectable rainfall amounts. Our monsoon high initially seemed to favor a position to our north, near areas of low snowpack and long-term drought. However, a series of low-pressure systems near the west coast pushed the high southeastward on several occasions. This ushered dry air from the southwest into Arizona, which prevented a moist east or southeast flow from becoming entrenched that would have been favorable for a more persistent pattern of daily thunderstorms. This influx of dry air especially affected locations from Tucson north and west. A consensus of longer-term computer models indicated that both the June through August and July through September periods would end up wetter than normal across much of the western United States, including southeast Arizona, as shown here in green in both graphics. So how do these factors change going forward? Current indications favor a slight weakening of low pressure near the west coast, which could give our monsoon high a chance to become more dominant as shown on the left. That means that moist southeast flow could become established for a week or two during the latter half of August. So that's one indication of possible wetter weather to come. The forecast for a continued strengthening of El Nino shown in the center graph would likely mean increased activity in the tropics, especially in September and maybe into October. That's another indication of possible wetter weather to come during the second half of the monsoon. Finally, on the right, the latest climate models are indicating higher probabilities of wetter weather in the offing for August through October. Putting all those factors together, among others, climate scientists at the Climate Prediction Center have projected that the month of August and the period of August through October are more likely to be wetter than normal than they are to be either drier than normal or experience near normal precipitation. The darkening shades of green shown on the map on the right mean that chances for above normal rainfall are higher for the 3-month period than they are for just the month of August. Looking ahead to this winter, the outlook is for an even higher probability of wetter than normal weather in southeast Arizona for the period December through February. This is mainly thanks to that strengthening El Nino, which during winter tends to lead to a favorable track of winter storms across Arizona. During the last moderate to strong El Nino of 2009 to 2010, southeast Arizona experienced a wet winter with plentiful high elevation snow. We'll update the winter outlook and the potential impacts toward the end of September after we see how this monsoon plays out. Again, stay tuned for additional climate briefings as the monsoon ends and we look forward to winter. Thanks for listening to this presentation. For additional information about the monsoon, climate prediction, and monsoon safety, see the websites listed here. All of these are linked from the National Weather Service Tucson website, weather.gov/Tucson.